subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
I'm going to give you the most important questions coming to polynomials. Okay? Polynomials, class 10th. Okay, if you prepare these questions, you're going to get really good score in your exam, and the students who are going to attempt the supplementaries and the compartment exams, if you follow these questions, you can easily pass in your exam. Okay, so first important question is, if the sum of zeros of the quadratic polynomial three x square minus kx plus 6 is 3, then find the value of k. Very, very important question. See, they are saying if the sum of zeros of quadratic polynomial, this is quadratic polynomial, okay? If the sum of zeros of this quadratic polynomial is 3, then what is the value of k? Okay, so now let's see how to solve this problem. Let's take given equation 3x square minus kx plus 6 is equal to 3. This is the given equation. So we can write this in the form of ax square minus bx plus c is equal to 3. See, students, I'm repeating this point. We can also write this equation in the form of ax square minus bx plus c is equal to 3. Okay, till now you understood it, right? So now, using these both equations, let's write out the values of a, b and c. Okay, value of a is, in place of a, there is 3. Okay, till here you understood? In place of a, there is 3. In place of b, there is minus k. Okay, there is minus k. You can ask me one doubt here. Ma'am, we didn't consider minus, no? Why are you saying B is minus K? B can be written as K also, no, madam? You can ask me, okay? See, I'll explain you this in more detailed way. Minus B is equal to K. It is nothing but B is equal to minus K, because minus we are sending into right hand side, so it simultaneously at the final step it became b is equal to minus k. Okay, so next, c value is 6. Till here you understood, right? So with the help of the given equation, we have derived a value, b value and c value. Okay, so now what we need to do is, they are saying if the sum of zeros is 3, it seems. So sum of zeros is 3. They gave this. Sum of zeros is value 3. They gave it. Okay. So sum of zeros can be written as alpha plus beta. Okay. Sum of zero can be also written as alpha plus beta. Till here you understood, right? Here the formula is, so I'm rubbing this equation as we got the values of a, b and c. So sum of values is given alpha plus beta. This is the formula. Okay, alpha plus beta can also be written as minus b by a. This is given. Minus b by a is equal to 3. This part is given. Okay. So till here you understood, right? Sum of zeros are nothing but sum of zeros formula is alpha plus beta, which can also be written as this minus b by a. And the value of sum of zeros is already given as 3. So I wrote directly is equal to 3. We are just substituting the values of a and b instead of these alphabets. Okay. Minus b by a is equal to 3 can also be written as, what is minus b? Okay. B value is minus k by a value is 3. Is equal to 3. Okay, so minus into minus becomes plus. Plus k by 3 is equal to 3. Till here you understood, right? So now what we need to do, k by 3 is equal to 3. 3 goes this side. Okay, when division goes to the opposite side, it becomes multiplication. So k is equal to 3 into 3. So the value of k is 9. So like this, you need to solve the problems. Okay. I'm explaining this problem again. Listen carefully. They are saying if the sum of zeros of the given polynomial is 3, we need to find out the value of k. Okay. So see here, students, carefully. 3x square minus kx plus 6 can also be written as ax square minus bx plus 6. Okay. So a value is 3, b value is minus k, and c value is 6. Okay. So now sum of zeros formula is alpha plus beta, which can also be written as minus b by a. And we are just substituting the values in this equation, in this minus b by a, and solving. So finally, we got the value of k, which is 9. So like this, you need to solve problem carefully. Okay. The question is, verify whether 2, 3 and 1 by 2 are zeros of the polynomial p of x is equal to 2x cube minus 11x square plus 17x minus 6 Okay. See here what they are asking. Verify whether 2, 3 and 1 by 2 are zeros of polynomial of the given equation. This is the question. So now let's see how to solve this question. Okay. So coming to the solution, first let's take the equation which they give. P of x is equal to 2x cube minus 11x square plus 17x minus 6. Okay. And first let's take 2 in the place of x. They gave 2, 3 and 1 by 2. First let's see. They gave 2, 3, 1 by 2. First let's take 2 in the place of x. Okay. So P of 2 is equal to 2 into 2 cube minus 11 into 2 square plus 17 into 2 minus 6. Okay. We did nothing, just in place of x, we took 2. That's it. Okay. So now after solving this equation, we will get 16 minus 44 plus 34 minus 6 is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0 is, they clearly told, zeros. Okay. So this is the equation we got. Till here, I hope you understood. After solving this, 16 minus 6, 10. 10 minus 44 plus 34. 10 plus 34 is 44. 44 minus 44 is 0. Okay, so after substituting 2 in the place of x, we got the value 0. Okay, so now we are repeating the same step by taking x is equal to 3. So when taking x is equal to 3, same. P of 3 is equal to 2 into 3 whole cube, 3 cube minus 11 into 3 square plus 17 into 3 minus 6. Okay. So after solving the complete equation, we will get 0. Okay. After solving whole equation, we will get 0. So students, P of 2 is equal to 0 and P of 3 is also is equal to 0. I am taking x is equal to minus 1 by 2 value and substituting. So P of 1 by 2 is equal to 2 into 1 by 2 whole cube minus 11 into 1 by 2 whole square plus 17 into 1 by 2 minus 6. Okay. So now let's see how to solve this. Okay, we are just taking the right hand equation and solving. Left side it will be common, it will be P of 1 by 2 only. So right side how to solve, let's see. Okay, 2 into 1 by 1 by 2 whole cube can be written as 2 by 8. Okay, 2 by 8 minus 11 into 1 by 2 whole square value will be 11 by 4 plus 17 into 1 by 2 can be written as 17 by 2 and leftover number is minus 6. So now here we need to solve this. 2 by 8 can also be written as 1 by 4. 1 by 4 minus 11 by 4 plus 17 by 2 minus 6. Till here, all clear. Did you get it till here? Now we need to solve the entire equation. Taking the denominator as 4 into 1. Because 4 ones are 4, right? Because here the denominator we have 4. So we just need to multiply with 1. 1 minus, here also denominator is 4. So just multiply with 1. Minus 11 plus, here denominator is 2, so we need to multiply with 2, then only we get 4, like 2 into 2 is 4, right? So 17 into 2, what is 17 into 2? It is 34, okay? Minus, here we don't have any denominator, so we need to multiply by 4, minus 6 fours are, so after solving this, we will get 0 by 4, whose value is 0. So students, when we substitute the given values in the given polynomial, we get P of 1 by 2 is 0, P of 2 is 0 and P of 3 is 0. So yes, x is equal to 2 comma 3 comma 1 by 2, all are zeros of the given polynomial. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today, students. Hope you found this video useful. These two questions are most common and very, very important questions. Concentrate on these questions. And I am also going to make videos on complete chapters explanation also. And I'm also going to give more and more important questions for you. So if you wanted more and more such kind of videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video whenever I make a new video. And also don't forget to like and share this video. Let's make this video reach 10k likes and let's make our channel reach 20k subscribers. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.